Hello. Awareness is the key to be healthified. You know, multiple mechanisms exist in our bodies to eliminate toxic waste. However, you may experience complications like high creatinine levels when the mechanisms fail. Such complications may cause serious health issues. If you are wondering what that optimum creatinine level are and why they should be balanced, this video may help clear your doubts. Watch more about the causes of high creatinine levels, symptoms, risk factors, and treatment options. But what is creatinine? Creatinine is a metabolic product of creatine and a byproduct of muscle metabolism. Creatinine is a significant molecule that helps in the production of energy and improves exercise performance. About 2% of our body's creatine is converted to creatinine and transported to your kidneys via the bloodstream. Your kidneys filter out most of the creatinine and eliminate it from your body through urine. Low urine creatinine levels may be an indication of high blood creatinine, and it could be a cause of concern in some cases. Normal creatinine levels. The creatinine levels in your body are usually dependent on your muscles, mass, gender, age, and other health conditions. They are often measured in milligrams per deciliter. Adult males should have 0.9 to 1.3 milligram per dl, adult females 0.7 to 1.1 milligram per dl, infants 0.2 milligram per dl, individuals with one kidney 1.8 to 1.9 milligram per dl. Older people have lower creatinine levels than normal adults, and bodybuilders may have higher creatinine levels than most adults. This is because older individuals have diminished muscles while bodybuilders have more muscles as compared to most normal individuals. Also, individuals with any muscle-related disorder may have significantly lower creatinine levels. Why should creatinine levels be lowered? High blood creatinine can pose a danger if left untreated. May damage kidneys. Elevated creatinine levels, if left untreated, can damage kidneys. Renal failures may also occur if blood creatinine levels exceed the natural limits or with the intake of excess creatine supplements. According to a report by the Centers of Disease Control and Prevention, chronic kidney disease is more common in people aged 65 years or older, 38% than in people in the age group of 45 to 64 years, 12% and 18 to 44 years, 6%. It is more common in women, 14%, than men, 12%. The estimates are based on a single measure of serum creatinine. May increase the risk of cardiovascular disease. High creatinine levels increase your risk of developing cardiovascular disease, may lead to respiratory disorder. An increase in creatinine levels may lead to respiratory disorder. However, the relationship between elevated creatinine level and respiratory disorders remains unclear. How to lower creatinine levels? Medical solutions to lower creatinine levels like dialysis and other treatments and medications can be daunting. However, if you want to go the natural route, you may have some suggestion that may help. Here's how you can try lowering your creatinine level with natural remedies. Number 1. Apple cider vinegar. Kidney stone formation may slightly elevate serum creatinine levels. Apple cider vinegar contains acetic acid, which may lower the risk of kidney stone formation. Its antimicrobial properties may help ward off bacterial infections and may prevent your blood creatinine levels from increasing, but scientific research is lacking in this aspect. Add a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar to a glass of warm water and mix well. Add some honey to this solution. Drink the solution once daily, preferably with a high carbohydrate diet. Number 2. Bitter gourd. Bitter gourd is a rich source of various minerals, vitamins, antioxidants, and fibers. Anecdotal evidence suggests that it may act as a natural diuretic, improves blood circulation, and tonifies your kidneys to help lower your blood creatinine level naturally. However, limited research is available in this regard. Drink half a cup of bitter gourd juice once daily. Don't consume bitter gourd or its juice in excess. A study on mice has shown that 4000 mg per kg is the tolerable range. Any dose exceeding this is nephrotoxic. However, human studies are to be conducted in this regard. Number 3. Cinnamon is thought to be a natural diuretic. Some believe it may also improve the kidney's filtration abilities, though more research is warranted to understand this, but cinnamon does regulate the body's creatinine levels. Mix half a tablespoon of cinnamon in warm water or food and consume once a day. Number 4. Chamomile tea. Ingestion of chamomile tea may lower high creatinine levels. Add chamomile herb to a cup of hot water. Allow it to steep for at least 10 minutes. Strain and add a little honey. You can have chamomile tea 3 to 4 times daily. Number 5. Green tea. Green tea is a natural antioxidant and has diuretic properties. The diuretic nature of green tea may help improve the filtration ability of your kidneys and increase urine output, thereby lowering creatinine levels. Steep a green tea bag in a cup of hot water for about 10 minutes. Allow it to cool for a while and add some honey. You can drink green tea 2 to 3 times daily. Number 6. Garlic. Garlic is a natural antioxidant and acts as a diuretic. It helps flush out toxic waste from our body and may help lower blood creatinine levels. Garlic also increases the level of plasma iron and improves hemoglobin levels. You can chew 4 to 5 garlic cloves, or you can add minced garlic to your salads and other foods. You must do this 1 to 2 times daily. Number 7. Ginger. Ginger contains flavonoids and ethanol that exhibit antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, which can help protect your kidneys from damage and injury and lower the creatinine levels in your body. Add 1 inch of ginger to a cup of hot water and allow it to steep for at least 10 minutes. Add a little honey and consume immediately. You can drink this ginger tea thrice daily for optimum benefit. Cranberry juice. Cranberries contain quinic acid that protects your kidneys from stone formation. Drink a medium cup of cranberry juice once a day. Coconut water. Tender coconut water is a rich source of vitamin C that can lower your creatinine levels and keep your kidneys healthy and stone-free. Have a glass of tender coconut water once a day. Avoid consuming more than 1 glass of coconut water in a day. Anecdotal evidence suggests that it may affect your kidneys. Number 10. Olive oils. Olive oils exhibit anti-urolithic activities that can help prevent the formation of kidney stones. It may also reduce creatinine levels in the blood. Add a tablespoon of olive oil to your salad or pasta once daily. Avoid heating olive oil too much while using it in food preparations. In addition to include these foods in your diet, you may also need to avoid certain foods to lower creatinine levels and aid in certain high creatinine treatments. What food should be avoided if creatinine levels are high? Number 1. Spinach. Spinach is high in potassium. Additionally, it is also high in oxalates and may increase the risk of kidney stones. Canned food. Canned foods are high in sodium. It is added as a preservative to increase the shelf life. The sodium may also detrimental effects on kidney function and may also worsen existing symptoms. Dairy products. Dairy products are a rich source of phosphorus. Individuals that with chronic kidney disease should limit the consumption of dairy, as this phosphorus may interfere with calcium balance. It also may lead to a buildup of protein waste in the body and exert pressure on the kidneys. Beverages. Colored beverages are loaded with phosphorus to enhance their appearance and taste. However, if you are having any kidney complications, it is better to avoid all kinds of artificial beverages, as their phosphorus content can burden the kidney. Whole wheat bread. Whole wheat bread is rich in phosphorus, potassium, and sodium and may be unsuitable for people with kidney-related ailments. The whole grains in whole wheat bread may have a high percentage of sodium than that of white bread. In addition to these, processed foods, fried chips, and pickles are also to be avoided because of their high sodium content. Here is what you can do to reduce the risk of high creatinine levels in your blood and figure out how to control creatinine levels. Some preventive tips. Avoid taking creatinine supplements, as they may increase the risk of creatinine deposition. However, there is only limited research in this regard. Reduce protein intake, as it may aggravate protein deposition. deposits in the body and spike creatinine levels. Consume more fiber-rich foods like whole grains, legumes, vegetables, and fruits. Anecdotal evidence suggests that excess intake of salt may have detrimental effects on kidney functions, so it is advised to reduce excessive salt intake. Practice yoga asanas like mean half spinal twist after consulting your doctor. Now that you know how to reduce creatinine level, let us look into the factors that cause the increase. Causes of high creatinine level. If the functioning of your kidney is interrupted or impaired by any condition, it can cause your creatinine level to go high. Some of the most common causes of chronic kidney diseases or elevated creatinine levels in adults include diabetes. Diabetes may sometimes lead to an increase in creatinine levels. High blood pressure. Uncontrolled blood pressure levels may result in an elevation of creatinine levels in the body. Urinary tract infections. Urinary tract infections may cause a spike in creatinine levels. However, clear research is lacking in this regard. Drug like simetidine. Simetidine is used to treat stomach acidity and peptic ulcers. Regular consumption of simetidine may increase the levels of creatinine. Some symptoms of high creatinine level will be described in this video. The high creatinine symptoms and kidney dysfunctions often vary widely and may not be correlated with each other. Some individuals may have severe kidney diseases and high creatinine levels without displaying any symptoms, while others usually develop symptoms like swelling or edema, shortness of breath, dehydration, fatigue, nausea or vomiting, confusion. It is very important to get your kidneys diagnosed periodically if you have high creatinine levels. Some diagnosis methods that can be used to screen your kidneys for any abnormalities are discussed. Diagnosis. If you have high creatinine level, then blood test will reveal the exact situation. Number 1. Blood urea nitrogen test or BUN. This test checks the functioning of your kidneys by measuring the amount of urea nitrogen in your blood. A very low creatinine level or high increased BUN and creatinine often hint at kidney problems. Glomerular filtration rate test. This test reveals the filtration rate of the substances through the glomerulus. The normal GFR rate is 90 to 120 ml per minute in a healthy adult. Anything less may indicate kidney malfunction and elevated creatinine levels. Urine analysis. In this test, urine is analyzed physically and chemically, revealing the presence of protein, glucose, and red blood cells. Creatinine is a waste product produced after creatine metabolism that must be eliminated via the urine. High creatinine levels can be harmful to your general well-being if left unaddressed. It may lead to kidney, cardiovascular, and respiratory disorders. So, be aware and be healthy. Take care. Bye-bye.